Myself, Manjusha Bhoyar, working as an assistant professor in Zoology, Arts, Commerce and Science College, RB. Today, the topic which I am explaining is lysosome. So, students, everybody know that what is lysosome. We have seen in the previous chapters, we have seen what is cell biology. So, in this cell biology, this lysosome, it is very important. So, what is the origin of lysosome? First, who discovered this lysosome? Lysosome was discovered by Christian De Dubé in 1955. So this how the lysosome originated? So some of the scientists say that it is originated from plasma membrane. Some of the scientists say that it is originated from nuclear membrane. Some say that it is originated from ER, and some say that it is originated from Golgi complex. But the main origin of the lysosome, it is from the Golgi complex. So now we will see how is the structure of lysosome, ultrastructure of lysosome. The structure of lysosome is very simple. It is just a spherical structure having a lipoprotein membrane. The membrane, it is made up of lipid and protein, just similar to the chemical nature of the plasma membrane. So this lysosome, usually it is originated from the Golgi complex. So from the Golgi complex, some of the vesicles, they are budded off by pinching process, and these vesicles, when they are budded off, it is called as secretory vesicles. These secretory vesicles, it contains this secretory vesicle, it may contain different types of chemicals, such as different type of substances which are stored in the secretory vesicle. It may be lipid, it may be protein, it may be carbohydrate, or it may sometimes contain some hydrolytic enzyme. And if the vesicle, if it contains strong enzymes or hydrolytic enzyme or degradative enzyme, it is called as lysosome. So the lysosome, it is nothing but a spherical structure which arises from the Golgi complex. And this spherical structure, it is called as the first structure which arises from Golgi complex, it is called as primary lysosome. It contains strong enzyme, hydrolytic enzyme. Now this, we will see the different kinds of lysosome. So there is a polymorphism in lysosome. First type of lysosome which arises from Golgi complex, it is called as primary lysosome. Second lysosome, which the structure which is formed, it is called as heterophagosome. Now we will see how the heterophagosome is formed. So the heterophagosome, it is a structure which is formed by the fusion of extracellular material, or it is formed by the combination with phagosome or pinosome. This phagosome or pinosome, it comes from outside the plasma membrane. Along with the food, it enters from the plasma membrane inside the cell. This food particle, it combines with the primary lysosome. The primary lysosome, it mixes the hydrolytic enzyme, it digests the food particle. This food particle, when it digests the food particle, the digestion is completed. Sometimes when this structure which is formed, it is called as heterophagosome or secondary lysosome. Sometimes what happens, when the digestion takes place, if the lysosomal enzyme, it is in insufficient amount, then the digestion, it is incomplete, and the remains of the food material remains inside this vesicle, and the incomplete digested material, it is called the structure which is formed in this vesicle. The indigested material which is found in this vesicle, it is called as a residual body. This is the secondary lysosome. Now this secondary lysosome, it contains the waste material. This waste material has to be excreted out of the membrane. So this residual body, it comes near the plasma membrane, it fuses with the plasma membrane, and this material, it is defecated out of the plasma membrane by exocytosis process. When the food material enter inside the cell, it is called as endocytosis process. When the food material, nitrogen waste substances, when they are thrown outside the cell, it is called as exocytosis process. So these are the heterophagosome, residual body, these are the secondary lysosome. Again, some of the food, sometimes the lysosome, it digests the intracellular material. Intracellular material means if the cell get damaged, if the half of the cell get damaged, this cell, it is repaired or it is remodeled by this lysosomal enzyme. The lysosome, the last type of lysosome, it is called as autolysosome. Autolysosome means This lysosome sometimes it accidentally break or it digests the complete cell if it is injured, and then the damaged cells are removed or the remnants of the cells are removed, and these cells when it is removed, it is called as autolysosome. So this lysosome, it is also referred as suicide bags of the cell. So these are the intracellular digestion, extracellular digestion, these are the functions of lysosome. Now we will see the functions of lysosome. The functions of lysosome, extracellular digestion. So we have seen the extracellular digestion, that is heterophagosome, how it works. Then we have seen the intracellular digestion means the autolysosome. It digests the internal part of the cell, that is the intracellular digestion. Then lysosome, it is very important in developmental process. So we know that during menstruation, the menses which are removed outside the body, or during the pregnancy period, we know that the extra muscles in the mammary glands and the uterus, it is shed off by the secretion of this lysosomal enzymes. Now in cell division, the cell division, it is initiated, it plays an important role in cell division. In cell division, this lysosome, it initiates the cell to undergo the cell division. Now in the acrosome reaction, we know that the structure of sperm, the head of the sperm, it contains the acrosome region, and this inside this acrosome there is a hydrolytic enzyme present. This hydrolytic enzyme, it is very acidic in nature, and when the sperm it comes in contact with the eggs, the outer layer of the eggs, they are dissolved, and the process, it is during fertilization, this acrosome, it plays an important role for the fusion of sperm nucleus with the egg nucleus. So next function is the lysosome and disease. So as lysosome, it is very important for repairing the cell, for the digestion of the extracellular, intracellular material. It also has some bad effects. Sometimes accidentally, if the lysosomal enzyme, when the lysosome are released inside the cell, these enzymes, it may damage the 21st number of chromosome in man, and this, if the 21st pair of chromosome is damaged, it leads to the blood cancer or leukemia. Sometimes there are many diseases caused by the lysosome. It may cause joint pains, hypertension, heart failure, congestive. So some of the diseases are caused by the lysosome. So this is the short summary which I have given about the structure of lysosome and the functions of lysosome. Thank you.